Mr. Fitzhugh accomplished something that no art collector would undertake in smuggling these jade burial tablets out of China. I have an international reputation as a collector of jade, yet not even I would attempt it.
The thing that gets me is why anybody'd want burial tablets around. Personally, they give me the creeps.
Oh, but Captain, you're not a collector of jade, or you would understand. Besides, Senator Baldwin commissioned me to buy them at a price of $50,000. You know, a man will take quite a few chances for $50,000.
Yeah, but the 50 G's won't be much good to you if these guys knock you off the way they say they're going to.
I understand that perfectly. That's why I came to you. My life is in danger. These men, whoever they are, have set tonight at midnight as the hour of my execution. But if I'm in jail under guard, they can't possibly kill me. You see?
Yeah, I get it. You want us to lock you up so they can't get at you.
Exactly.
Sorry, Mr. Fitzhugh, but we can't do it. Our job is to catch criminals.
And to protect people from criminals, Captain. I demand you lock him up.
Now, just a minute, Doctor, not so fast. We're going to protect Mr. Fitzhugh, all right. But at the same time, we're going to catch these guys who are threatening his life.
You say you got the first one of these notes the day you got off the boat from China?
That's right. While opening my luggage at the dock for the custom inspector, I found it pinned on a coat in my wardrobe trunk.
See who that is.
Yes, sir.
And if it's who I think it is, throw her out.
Right, Chief.
Oh! Step aside, Gahagan, and let a lady in.
Now, quit kidding, Torchy. You ain't no lady. You're a reporter. And I just got orders to throw you out.
Oh, Gahagan, you wouldn't do a thing like that, would you?
Now, Torchy, you stop bumping my stomach.
You ought to start reducing, Gahagan. That thing's in everybody's way.
Never mind that thing. Orders is orders.
Oh, Gahagan.
Now, listen, Torchy. I never raised a hand to a lady in my life, but...
You don't have to. With a bay window like that... Now, listen, you go in and tell that big lug...
I ain't gonna tell that big lug nothing. I mean, Steve. Now, scram.
Oh, isn't that pretty?
It is, ain't it?
Let me have a look at that note. Dr. Mann's really sure this ain't a laundry ticket.
I'm quite sure. Captain Condon here is familiar with Chinese. He served the British government on many secret missions in China. Suppose you translate it for him, Condon.
Yeah, do that, will you?
It says the price for ignoring our past warnings is death. You'll pay that penalty at 12 tonight. Dragon, I imagine, is some sign of some Chinese secret order. No doubt about it, Lieutenant. Fitzhugh is marked for death.
Well, they won't get away with it. Where do you live?
Adventurers Club on Lexington Avenue.
Cap, I'll run up there and look the place over.
Okay, Steve.
If these guys try to knock you off tonight, we'll give them a reception and it'll go down in history. Come on, let's go.